Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about build adaptations. I'm going to explain a few basic concepts about changing and replacing utility skills, and we will explore the theoretical background behind making build adjustments. This video is mostly about DPS builds, but also applies to some supports. The rule of 2000. Let us start with a controversial idea. Let's assume a DPS class, in my case Staff Daredevil, does around 35,000 DPS. It's going to be more for many classes, but let's roll with that number. Strip down the build to the bare minimum, the weapon choice, without stats, and the elite spec choice, Daredevil, Staff. Hitting the golem over the head with this Daredevil build produces about 3400 DPS. This serves as our baseline. Let us now count the choices we make when deciding on our build. We choose food, utility, runes, two sigils. We make 11 trait choices. If we take the elite spec as a given and choose 3 traits per line and choose 2 core trait lines, that's 11. And we make 14 gear stat choices, as well as 4 utility skill choices. And we don't count the heal skill here because that's not relevant to DPS on most classes. If we sum those choices up, we end at a total of 34 choices. Among those choices, there are 13 build-defining choices that are typically very impactful. Like they give +300 stats of something, or even more. These impactful choices are 5 trinkets, 3 grandmaster traits, 2 trait line choices, the armor stats of your chest piece, the weapon stat choice, and rune choice. If we value each of those as increasing our DPS by 10%, we arrive at a total of 11,700 DPS. In practice, I have hit about 13,700 DPS with this Daredevil build. That's because a few of those choices are a lot stronger than 10% DPS. The Deadly Art straight line choice alone gives us a 20% damage modifier against a target with 10 conditions on it. But for the moment, let's just stick with the 11,700 DPS figure. We now want to find the value of the remaining 21 choices. Solving for X gives X equals 5.35%. This means that each of the other choices on average has an effect of boosting the DPS by about 5.35%. Removing one of the choices therefore costs about 1872.5 DPS. Or, let's round it up, it costs about 2000 DPS. So, do you want to know how much you lose when you take boon duration food? About 2000 DPS. But what happens if you replace one utility skill by something else? Minus 2000 DPS. Then, plus whatever that other skill gives you. What happens if... anything. You can replace anything. What happens if you make any change? Minus 2000 DPS. The answer to all build-related questions is minus 2000 DPS. Now, this is obviously not accurate at all. Some choices you make are more impactful than others. Even in the non-essential bucket, there are differences. There are classes where one utility skill is massively overpowered and responsible for a much bigger DPS gain, while some traits aren't DPS traits at all, so they have zero impact. Squad support is even more difficult to quantify in this way, though the approximation 100 stats equals about 2.5% DPS will probably help you. The weakest link of your utility skills. For simplicity, let's focus on the three utility skills in the middle. To nobody's surprise, not all utility skills are equally strong. Among your choices, you pick the three with the highest damage impact. The most valuable one might be worth 2500 DPS. The second might be worth 2000 DPS, and the third might be worth 1000 DPS. These are just example numbers. So, when a boss fight demands that you pick an alternative utility skill, whether that is a Sanctuary on a Firebrand, Stand Your Ground on a Dragon Hunter, Spectral Grasp on a Reaper, Corrosive Poison Cloud on a Scourge, Feedback on an Axe Mirage, you need to know about three things. Number one, replacing utility skills will cost you around 2000 DPS. Refer back to the rule of 2000. And this loss of 2000 DPS is generally acceptable, and compared to the extra utility, it is certainly worth making the sacrifice. Second point is, you will replace always the weakest link in your utility skills first. This ensures that it is basically always less than 2000 DPS that you lose, because if the weakest utility skill was worth more than 2000 DPS, that's a lot of DPS bound to your utilities. I can't think of a DPS class right now where that's really the case. Maybe you can leave a comment if your main class has one of these skill sets where all utility skills are just broken. And number three, some of the replacement skills you could bring, like Sword of Justice on Condi Firebrand, Pitfall on Daredevil, Phantasmal Defender on a Power Chronomancer, Wild Blow on a Berserker, some of these choices actually return some DPS directly. So the actual loss compared to the Golem benchmark might be more around 1000 DPS or even less than that. This has consequences. It is typically feasible to replace the weakest utility skill you have. However, the cost of replacing a second utility skill is already steeper, both in an individual sense and also in a cumulative sense. The losses just add up. And replacing the final utility skill you had might break the functionality of your build entirely. Sick M on Power Soul Beast, Blade of Processions on Dragon Hunter, Purging Flames on a Condition Firebrand, Blood is Power on a Scourge, and other examples for other classes, these skills are basically mandatory skills for your DPS output. Having replaced all three utility skills will cost you at least 6000 DPS, making you barely a DPS class anymore, and you should probably play something else if you have the need for all of these skills. The much better approach would be to spread out the utility skill requirements to as many different players as possible. Have each of them replace their weakest utility skill first, and then, if necessary and feasible, progressively replace stronger and stronger skills. I'll make an example. Imagine you have one Condition Firebrand and one Quickness Firebrand, and you want to have as much crowd control as possible, as well as one Stand Your Ground for stability. The Condition Firebrand plays Purging Flames, Mantra of Flame, and Signet of Wrath. The Quickness Firebrand plays Mantra of Potence, Purging Flames, and Signet of Wrath. I've sorted the skills by importance here, so Purging Flames does the most damage, but Mantra of Potence is mandatory for Quickness Firebrand, so it's even more important. Now, you could run the Hammer of Wisdom, Sanctuary, and Stand Your Ground on the Quickness Firebrand. But wait, this removes its ability to give quickness with the Quickness Mantra. That would force the Condition Firebrand to then also run Quickness Mantra in the first place, and even run Feel My Wrath as an elite, and you just accumulate more and more DPS losses this way. So, this is clearly a very bad idea. The Quickness Firebrand would just be a CC and stability slave at that point, and it would be not functional. A slightly better but still bad approach would be to run Hammer of Wisdom, Sanctuary, and Stand Your Ground on the Condition Firebrand instead. This leaves the Condition Firebrand in a non-functional state without its purging flames, and the quickness firebrand is still intact. So it's a bit better than the previous suggestion, but it's still very bad. The third option is to run Sanctuary on both and then run Stand Your Ground on the quick brand. This is better than the previous idea because Sanctuary is better card control than Hammer of Wisdom, but it still overrides the strongest damage skill on the quickness firebrand, Purging Flames. The ideal solution in this configuration would be to run Sanctuary on each of the firebrands and then Stand Your Ground on the condition firebrand. In this way, we have identified and replaced the weakest utility skills and spread out the replacements as much as possible to leave the builds alive. We could go further and say we need more crowd control now, so we also run Hammer of Wisdom on one or both of the firebrands. The problem with that is that this is going to override Purging Flames necessarily, and we will probably come to the conclusion that this will not be worth it no matter on which boss we need that CC. Let's make a slightly different example. Banner sharing, when two Berserkers are in the same squad. In that case, it is better to have each Berserker run only one banner, so both can run the combo of Outrage and Wild Blow to enable permanent Berserk uptime for both. This turns one full banner Berserker and one full DPS Berserker into two DPS Berserkers that only lack 180 power from the Signet each. So in that case, by spreading out the utility of the banners, we made one build a bit weaker and the other build a lot stronger. Having understood these concepts, we can now get to the final chapter. What is the weakest link? I will now go over some of the classes to answer what the weakest link is in each case. If you are a main or a theory crafter on one of those classes, feel free to correct me, as I am not 100% sure on each of them, and I certainly can't quantify the effects of every skill. And things might also change with patches and reworks of skills, so take all of this with a grain of salt. Condition Axe Mirage. Crystal Sands is theoretically the weakest utility skill, but removing it changes your rotation and it might mess with your muscle memory. So you might opt to remove the Signet of Domination first, because 180 condition damage is slightly weaker than 180 expertise, so Signet of Midnight will be slightly stronger. Alacrity Staff Mirage. Crystal Sands is mandatory to maintain Alacrity here, so you should replace one of the Signets, preferably the one with the condition damage. Power Chronomancer. Mantra of Pain is your weakest skill DPS-wise, but if you somehow precast clones in the fight, like on the Doom fight where you can precast clones on the spiders in the pre-event, then you might want to replace Mirror Images instead. Condition Scourge. Shadow Fiend is a joke DPS-wise. You can always replace it by any utility you need, be that Epidemic or Corrosive Poison Cloud or Sandswell. The Signet can be replaced on fights where life force generation is not an issue because lots of adds are dying or you're running a group with many Condi Renegades who feed life force into the Scourge. Blood is Power is overpowered. Keep it. Staff Daredevil. If you have Spotter, you will not notice losing Signet of Agility, and you can compensate your gear to make up for the lost position. If you don't have Spotter, you should definitely adjust your gear to make up for the loss. If you can, keep your other utility skills. Condition Daredevil. All skills are basically mandatory, since they are a major contribution to your DPS. You can replace the trap if you have to pick one of them. Power Soul Beast. Signet of the Wild can go first, then Frost Trap. They are close in DPS over a longer fight, but when you are just bursting, you want to keep the trap. Condition Soul Beast. The trap is your weakest skill. Then comes Vulture Stance, unless you have super good condi allies with it in your subgroup, and Sharpened Edges is your strongest skill. Conditioned Firebrand. Purging Flames needs to stay. The other two utility skills are about equally strong. It depends a bit on the phase timings of the boss. Quickness Firebrand. Mantra of Potence is mandatory for quickness. Purging Flames is a great skill, and Signet of Wrath can be replaced. Power Dragon Hunter. Sword of Justice can go. The other two utility skills should be kept if possible. Banner Berserker. The banners need to stay. Signet of Might can be replaced. Renegade. So, in general, Renegade doesn't get to choose its utility skills. The only thing it gets to choose is its legends that determine the whole set of utility skills. So, making a change of legend might result in a huge DPS drop because you potentially replace many good utility skills. That being said, for Condition Renegade, if you for some reason have to replace any legend, then you need to keep Malix and you can drop Color. It will lose you DPS, but if there is a better use, that would be the replacement you want to make. This sums up the classes I know things about. Feel free to correct me on any of the classes I've mentioned here and share your opinion on others. If your class wasn't mentioned here, go with the rule of 2000 DPS and your gut feeling to determine in what situation it is worth to drop which skill. Generally, crowd control on boss fights that stall progress when not CC'd, for example Slothosaur, Samurok and Serra, is well worth losing one utility skill for. Okay, this is me signing off for this year. It has been a real pleasure to be making these videos for you, and I hope to continue with it in 2022. Feel free to contact me if you have any video ideas, questions or feedback. Thanks for watching.